Well, John, thank you for taking the time to do this interview today with me and us, the viewers of the Orthotropics channel. When my children were 14, I've got twins, we met you for the first time. And they already had orthodontics, and the orthodontic said it would be good to, you know, get their teeth straight. But you have a different opinion about that.
Well, the real reason is, of course, you should ask why the teeth are crooked in the first place. The orthodontists believe it's genetic. And I am quite sure that it is environmental. It is obviously, there is a mix, but it is much more environmental than genetic.
What do you mean with environmental?
Well, environmental basically is our lifestyle. I think it's due partly to the fact that we live in houses, partly to the fact that we eat soft food, and partly to the fact that we only breastfeed for 3 to 6 months when it should be over 2 years.
And how can the fact that we live in houses make their teeth crooked?
Well, the houses contain dust, and dust contains allergens, which cause allergies. And if you have an allergy, your nose is very likely to be runny and often blocks. So you develop the habit of keeping the mouth open, and that destroys the natural environment required for good growth.
So leaving your mouth open because you have a blocked nose can turn your teeth crooked?
It can totally ruin your face, and I think that is much more important. If you look at me, my face is quite long. That's because when I was young, I left my mouth open. Fortunately, at the age of about 15, I thought I looked better with my mouth shut, and so at least I've got a bit of a chin. But if I hadn't done that, I would be much worse than I am. And I've now learned to keep my mouth shut with my tongue and my palate, and that naturally causes better growth.
Okay, so your treatment is called orthotropics, and there's not everybody is convinced that this actually works. So what kind of evidence do you have that it does work?
Well, essentially, my orthodontic colleagues and friends are quite sure it does not work. The main reason is that they have done many research projects where they have treated cases to try and make the face grow forward. Forward growth means good-looking growth. It also means room for all the teeth. It also means you don't have clicking jaw joints. And even more importantly, it prevents sleep apnea, which shortens people's lives by 10 years or more.
Why is that?
Well, if the face does not grow forward as it should do, then the throat is too narrow, too small, and it becomes difficult to breathe, particularly at night when the tongue drops to the back of the throat and many people are unable to breathe for long periods at night. And this most certainly does shorten their life.
Okay, but how can you prove that your method works?
Well, the problem with proof in this case is that my treatment is based on posture, the position of the tongue, the lips, and the jaw. Now, in science, you need to be able to measure things accurately so that you compare them scientifically. But no one has yet been able to measure posture. It's just not possible because it is continuous. And therefore, the universities are basically not interested in something they can't measure. Orthodontists measure things. They measure the change in millimeters and degrees. I simply treat cases and measure the result. Does it look good or does it look bad? Now, you can imagine that is very difficult to put numbers to. Therefore, the orthodontists say my research is not valid. But in reality, I have compared my treatment with their treatment on many occasions. On one occasion, I took a group of twins, identical twins. I treated one and asked the orthodontist to treat the other. In every case, the orthotropic results were highly significantly better. Now, that is a rare finding in orthodontics, to have something highly significantly better.
But if we look at the picture of Buddha, for example, that you send us, doesn't it genetically also occur that in that period of time, people's faces change from child to manhood, and the jaw with the hormones naturally will change?
Well, I think we know from experience that children very rarely grow from being unattractive to attractive, but often grow from being attractive to unattractive. Almost every child at the age of 6 or 7 is attractive. But at that point, the permanent teeth come in, and that is when appearance can be severely damaged by poor posture. If your tongue does not hold the upper jaw up, and particularly if you drop your lower jaw down, that will really spoil your appearance. Orthodontists really don't, I should say that, follow those thoughts at all. But orthotropics is designed entirely around that. That's why we treat patients at the age of 6, 7, or 8. And orthodontists mostly treat at the age of 12 to 15. Looking at Buddha, you can see that we treated him. He was told when he was young that he would have to have surgery to correct the position of his jaws. Mm-hmm. And his mother brought him to me and said, could you treat him without surgery? And I said, yes. But what we did was to reverse the pattern of growth to that age. And we started simply by moving the upper front teeth forward. Now, many people would say they were too far forward to begin with, but no, orthotropics believes the whole upper jaw should be much further forward. But we start by moving the upper front teeth, then we fit an appliance which corrects the posture. That's the way they hold their tongue, lips, and jaw. And that will then encourage the face to go forward, 15, 20 millimeters and more. Orthodontists, as I said earlier, can't get forward growth of more than 3 millimeters. But they never talk about that.
But is actually what you're saying, if your child has a good posture, it will never need braces?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And that is why we put our emphasis on training patients when they are very young. The problem is that a lot of clinicians and therapists give children exercises to keep their mouths shut with their tongue and the palate. But children are not very good at doing exercises. And in my experience, about 20% actually learn to correct their subconscious posture. That is where they naturally keep their tongue, lips, and jaw. They will do it for exercises and when they think about it, but the rest of the time they have poor posture, and hence they will get a poor result and an unattractive face.
Yeah, so actually you should teach your child from baby onwards to lips together.
Really, I do wish that people would consider the possibility that it is postural. Orthodontists, very, very few of them pay any real attention to posture. Some of them will send patients to a myotherapist who will give them exercises, but in reality, the vast majority of people have irregular teeth and long faces, or longer than they should. If you compare the skulls of people in the Stone Age, they had square faces and straight teeth, all of them. Now, in this day and age, very few children really look good after the age of six. It's quite a small proportion, and that's just due to poor posture.
Okay, so if there was a message to all parents with young children now that you would like to give them some advice, what would it be?
Well, I could say, sell your house and go and live in a cave in a mountain, but not many people would follow me. I could also say, eat rough, raw meat and never cook anything. Again, not many people would follow me. But I could also say, feed your child, breastfeed them naturally with no spoons, no cups, no bottles, until they're about 2.5 years, maybe 3 years old. Now, again, that is very unpopular. People want to get on with their lives. But in reality, we're talking about the quality of life. If you want to have a soft and easy life, you'll have to put up with an unattractive face, crooked teeth, clicking jaws, and a short life because you've got sleep apnea. But it is always either the parent's or the child's choice.
Well, thank you very much for this conversation. I hope you've inspired some people and at least to think about it. And also, you wrote a book about this for lay people to read.
Yes, that is, I think, a book that everybody should read. It's called What Will My Baby Look Like? It's really for young mothers. And it does tell them both what they can do and what might happen.
Well, thank you, John. And I will hope to see you again, maybe someday live.
Okay, anytime.